This is the second part of video, properties of sound. So first property of sound is loudness. Loudness is nothing but it will identify the feeble sound or whether the sound is good or loud sound or very weak sound. So this is called loudness. So always the loudness of a sound that tells about depends upon the amplitude. So what is meant by amplitude? Amplitude is nothing but it is the maximum displacement, nothing but maximum distance. So this is called distance or displacement. Maximum distance or maximum displacement of the vibrating particle from its mean position. The center line is called mean position or equilibrium position. From this, you are going to calculate the maximum distance or maximum displacement of the vibrating particle, that is called amplitude. So the loudness always depends upon the amplitude. From this you can find whether the sound is loud or very feeble or very weak. So always when the amplitude are higher, the sound will be very louder. When amplitude is lower, the sound also will be very feeble or sound also will be very lower. When a drum is softly beaten, what happens? A very weak sound is produced. But when the drum is beaten heavily, a loud sound is produced. So what is the unit of loudness? Decibel. D-E-C-I-B-E-L. Decibel. Amplitude unit is meter. And amplitude is denoted by the word A. Letter A. Second property is pitch. It is also one of the characteristic of sound that helps us to identify whether the sound is flat sound or shrill sound. When the frequency is high, pitch is high. The frequency is low, pitch is low. High pitch adds shrillness to a sound. For example, when the sound produced by flute or bell or whistle or violin are always high pitch sounds. The voice of a female always have high pitch compared to male voice. That is why female voice is shriller than a male's voice. So some of the example of low pitch sound is roar of a lion and the beating of a drum. Next up, property is quality or timbre. So quality or timbre, it is also one of the characteristic of sound that helps us to identify between the two sounds whether these two sounds have the same pitch and amplitude. If you take orchestra, the sounds produced by some of the musical instruments may have the same pitch and same loudness. So you can identify whether the sound produced by what is the sound that is produced by each instrument, nothing but quality or timbre. And fourth one is audibility and range. In the range varikum you can hear the sound. So according to frequency, there are three types of sound: audible sound, infrasonic sound and ultrasonic sound. Audible sound is nothing but when the sound ranges from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz is called audible sound or sonic sound. Audible sound or sonic sound, the humans can hear only this sound, the frequency ranging from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Human ears cannot hear the sound frequency that are below 20 hertz and are above 20,000 hertz. That above range is called audible range, as audible range of sound. So what is meant by infrasonic sound and ultrasonic sound? Infrasonic sound is nothing but frequency below 20 hertz. That is called infrasonic sound. But animals like dog, dolphin, they can hear this infrasonic sound. What is meant by ultrasonic sound? Whenever the frequency is greater than 20,000 hertz, that is called ultrasonic sound. Bats, dogs, dolphins, they can hear this ultrasonic sounds. So ultrasonic sounds, it is used in say echocardiography, nothing but it is also used in sonar system in order to find the depth of the sea and to find the enemy submarines. It is used in dishwashers and also in medicine areas. So these are the some of the uses of ultrasonic sound or ultrasonic waves. Not only that, for when you have say stone in kidney, no, these stones with the help of ultrasonic waves, no, the stones, they break down into small particles, and then that will just we can remove the stones. We can remove the stones with the help of passing these ultrasonic waves. So in this way, it is ultrasonic sounds are used in medicine field also. So bat know that bat can hear the sound or frequency that is above 20,000 hertz. Our next topic is musical instrument. So that is of four types. First one is wind instrument, reed instrument, stringed instrument, percussion instrument. Some sounds may be very pleasing. When you hear that music, it will be very happy. That is called music. So music also have regular patterns of vibrations. The first one is wind instrument. Wind means kaathu, air. With the help of air, when the sound is produced by the vibration of air in a hollow tube, say like flute, saxophone, sehanai, trumpet, these are some of the wind instruments. Reed instruments, say like harmonium, mouth organ, these instruments are called reed instruments. That means air which is blown through the environment causes the reed to vibrate, and that in turn produces some sound. Stringed instruments, with the help of strings, that also produces vibrations. So these instruments includes guitar, violin, sitar. These instruments, they have hollow boxes and that amplify the sound, and the sound is produced. A guitar string has number of frequencies and it will naturally vibrate. So those natural frequencies are known as harmonics of the guitar string. Next instrument name is percussion instrument. Percussion instrument, they produce a specific sound when they are struck or when they are scrapped or when they are clashed together. So this is one of the oldest type of instrument. Percussion instruments, say like drum, tabla, they all consist of a leather membrane skin that is made up of animal skin. So when it is stretched across a hollow box called the resonator, or when the membrane is hit, it starts vibrating and then it produces the sound. Let's say like tara, tappata, everything comes under this type of percussion type of instruments. And what are the sounds produced by humans? The sound is produced by human in voice box, that is called larynx, L-A-R-Y-N-X. So that is present in throat. The larynx has two main ligaments. One is vocal cords. So this vocal cords is very narrow slit. Here only the air is blown in and blown out. When a person speaks, no, the air from the lungs is pushed up through the trachea to the larynx. So when this air passes through the slit, what happens? The vocal cords, it begins to vibrate and it produces sound. So by varying the thickness of vocal cords, the length of the air column in the slit can be changed. So this only helps the people to produce different pitches of sound. Next thing is mechanism of human ear. The human ear is very, very important organ for all, even for animals, for human, everyone. Because our human ear, no, it picks up various different types of frequencies, vibrations of air. Say aquatic animals, the ears of aquatic animals are designed in order to pick very high frequency vibrations in water. So the outer part or visible part of the human ear is called pinna, that is curved in shape, pinna. So it is designed to collect with different vibration sound. It is designed to gather sound from the environment, which then it reaches our eardrum. Eardrum, it is inside, which reaches our eardrum through the ear canal. The sound wave strikes the drum. The ossicles move inward and outward to create the vibration. These vibrations are then picked up by special types of cells in our ear. From the inner ear, the vibrations are sent to the brain in the form of signals, and the brain receives these signals as sounds. Next one is noise pollution. Noise pollution, say any unwanted noise that is happening in street or even in school campus, when the noise is very louder, that is called noise pollution. So noise is produced always by irregular and non-periodic vibrations. This noise and all gives us stress. It may be loud or harsh sound, say like airplane or busy roads, electrical appliances, mixie, grinder, washing machine or untuned radio. These all produces noise pollution. When you use crackers, when you use loudspeakers for any function, these also creates noise pollution. And many noise pollution, they are also from industries. So what are different health hazards that is due to noise pollution? How our health is affected because of noise pollution? So noise, no, it will always cause irritation, stress, headache, nervousness, and also it won't allow us to sleep. When you hear a lot of noise or long term exposure to noise also make us to that may change the sleeping pattern of us, and sometimes it leads to loss of hearing also, heart attack or lack of concentration. These are some of the disadvantage or health hazard due to noise pollution. It always affects one peace of mind, one state of mind. It always creates some tension, high BP, short temper, adikadi kova padrathu. So these are some of the health hazards due to noise pollution. And how we will control this noise pollution? Controlling noise pollution means strict guidelines to be followed. Say the loudspeakers must not be allowed a social function or religious function, political occasions, we should not allow these loudspeakers. And automobiles, no, they should have effective silencer. Horns சில பேர் பயங்கரமாக அடிச்சுட்டே இருப்பாங்களே, அது மாதிரிலாம் இல்லாமல் ரொம்ப எஃபெக்டிவாக ஒரு சைலன்சர் வச்சுருக்கணும். அண்ட் பீப்புள் ஆல்சோ நீட் டு அவாய்ட் அன்னெசரி நாய்ஸஸ். அண்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ் ஆர் ஹோம் அப்ளைன்சஸ் அதெல்லாமே ப்ராப்பராக மெயின்டைன் பண்ணணும். எல்லா கம்யூனிகேஷன் ப்ராசஸும் இட் ஹேஸ் டு ஹேப்பன் ஒன்லி அட் லோ வால்யூம். அண்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ், ஃபேக்ட்ரிஸ், நாய்ஸி ஃபேக்ட்ரிஸ்லாம் இருக்கக்கூடாது. People should be encouraged to plant trees so that the plant trees know they will absorb the noises coming from around. Hearing loss. And you may have hearing loss without realizing. Namakke theriyama romba naala indha noise la ketitte irundha what happens? Kaadu valika aarambikum. A feeling or illness varum, fullness or fluid in the ear, kaadu valiya. And ringing in your ears, voice aging, ear infections varum. ஜெனட்டிக் டிஸார்டர் வரும். ஸோ லவுட் நாய்ஸ் கேட்டுகிட்டே இருந்தால் இது மாதிரி சில ப்ராப்ளம்லாம் வரும். ஸோ தஸ் வி கேம் டு தி எண்ட் ஆஃப் தி செஷன் அண்ட் திஸ் என்டையர் சாப்டர் இஸ் ஓவர். ஸோ இன் திஸ் என்டையர் சாப்டர் வி ஹவ் சீன் அபவுட் த ஃபஸ்ட் திங் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் மென் பை சவுண்ட் அண்ட் வாட் ஆர் தி டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆக்டிவிட்டீஸ் ஆர் எக்ஸ்பெரிமெண்ட்ஸ் தட் டெல்ஸ் அபவுட் தி வைப்ரேஷன்ஸ் ஆர் ப்ரொபகேஷன் ஆஃப் சவுண்ட் ஆர் ஹவு த சவுண்ட் இஸ் ப்ரொடியூஸ்ட் அதை பற்றி சொல்லியிருப்பாங்க. பில்ஜார் எக்ஸ்பெரிமெண்ட் ஆல்சோ தீர். And we have seen about waves, compression, rarefaction, longitudinal wave, transverse waves. And then we also seen different properties of sound. Say first one is loudness, second one is pitch, third one is quality or timbre, audibility and range. அதில் audible sound, infrasonic sound, ultrasonic sound என்னென்னு பார்த்தோம். மின் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட்ஸ், ரீட் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட்ஸ் பற்றி பார்த்தோம். அண்ட் தென் ஸ்ட்ரிஞ்சட் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட்ஸ், பெர்க்யூஷன் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட்ஸ் பற்றி பார்த்தோம். அண்ட் ஆல்சோ வி சீன் அபவுட் noise pollution and how to control this noise pollution, what are the different health hazards that causes and how to control this. Thus we come to the end of this chapter.